Hello everyone, myself Mohammad Abdul Rasool, Associate Professor CSE Department from Lords Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to the course on Fundamentals of Python. In this lecture, I am going to give an introduction, applications of Python, features of Python, identifiers and reserved words. Let us start with introduction part. Python is an high-level programming language. High-level in the sense, its syntax is very simple, easy to read. We are not bothering about the low-level tasks like memory management, security. Python is a general-purpose programming language. Its application we can use in variety of applications like machine learning, Internet of Things, deep learning, data analytics, like that. General purpose in the sense, earlier programming language like Fortran. Fortran is intended for only for scientific application, and COBOL is for only business application. But coming to the Python, it is a general purpose programming language we can use everywhere. Python was developed by Guido van Grassum in the year 1989 while working with National Research Institute, Netherlands. Later, Python officially released in the market in 1991. Python is recommended for beginners. In most of the universities, Python is opted as the beginning programming language in the place of C language because it doesn't require any programming knowledge. So it's recommended for beginners also. Now I am going to explain, before starting this introduction course, the main advantage of Python is the lines of codes are reduced. The number of lines are reduced. If you know or don't know about Java or C, I am going to compare Java as well as C language with our Python programming language. Now I am going to print a welcome to Lords string onto the output screen. So for that, in Java, I am going to write a main class name like welcome. After that, you have to call in the main class, you have to call main method. Then we have in that, we need to call the array of strings. Then using the output method of Java, system.out.println, welcome to Lords. After that, the main block is closed. Then we have the welcome block is closed. So in Java, you are going to get 7 lines of code in order to print welcome to Lords message onto the screen. Now we are going to verify what happening in C language. In C language, if you want to print welcome to Lords onto the output screen, I am going to include stdio.h, that is standard input and output header file that you need to include in the file. After that, you have to use the main method. In C language, in place of Java where we use system.out.println, in C language we are going to use an output function printf. So in printf, whatever output string you want to print onto the screen, welcome to Lords, that will be given in double quotes. So after that, we are closing the main function. So here in C, it is going to take 5 lines of code. Now coming to our Python programming language, I am going to print like English language statement using just print in place of that 5 lines or 7 lines. In Java, in Python, it is taking only 1 line of code. Print welcome to Lords. Or suppose I want to print any other string, like I want to print a string onto the output screen, online smart reader. I need to use only print. Print, in that I am going to use online smart reader. Directly it will be interpreted, the output you can see onto the output screen. Next we have same example 2 I am going to discuss. If you want to add two numbers, given two numbers in Java, in C and in Python. Now I am going to explain the Java program for the adding of given two numbers. Again you need to take a public class like add. In that class, main class, you have to call a main function, public static void main, array of strings. Then in that, Before adding two numbers, before initializing two numbers, you need to declare int a comma b, either it is integer or any other data type. So here these are integer I am going to declare. So I am assigning 10 value to a and 20 value to b. Later, using the standard output method system.out.println, the sum is, I am going to explain, the sum is, then the a plus b value I am going to print onto the output screen. The sum is using the concatenation operator in Java plus a plus b value I am printing onto the output screen. Later I am closing the compound statement main block, and after that it is add main class. So it is taking 10 lines of code in Java in order to add given two numbers. Next, I am going to explain about the C language for the same program, how it is taking, how many lines of code it is taking. Just you don't go through the logic whatever if you don't know the C and Java language. Just you count the number of lines it is taking to print the output of given two numbers, sum. Now I want to go with the C language program. So in C you need to use the again hash include stdio.h to include the standard input and output header files. So in the main method void main, you need to declare int a comma b, means a and b both you are declaring it as integer data type. After that 10 value, integer 10 you are assigning to a, and another integer value 20 you are assigning to b. After that, using the standard output function of C language, printf, the sum. After that you need to use percentile d, percentile d in order to print the decimal value, that answer. You need to use percentile d comma, then whatever resultant value you need to print, a plus b you are printing. So this much of hectic work you are doing in C language. Now coming to the Python, because it is a dynamically prototype language, no need to declare the data type here. While assigning, it will automatically treat. Now coming to the Python program, a is equal to 10, b is equal to 20 I took, and while assigning these, a is assumed as integer and b also assumed as integer. Directly using the standard output function of Python, that is print, the sum is, you are printing plus that whatever you have, a plus b. Now a plus b value is printed onto the output screen. Next we have, now coming to the history of Python. Why the name Python? Python is nothing but a big snake. Why Python name is given by our Guido van Rossum? Actually, Guido van Rossum is a fan of a comic show which was telecasted in BBC around the year 1969 to 1974. For 5 years in BBC channel it was telecasted. The comic show name was the Monty Python Flying Circus. The Monty Python Flying Circus, a comic show which was telecasted in BBC. So in that comic show, he liked the role of Python. Python is nothing but a snake in that. So he liked the snake role, Python role. That's why he has given the language name Python itself. Now coming to this, Guido van Rossum developed Python programming language by taking all the existing language features, whatever the good qualities every programming language is having. He did his research work and he found some good qualities in every programming language. So he took important features from almost all the programming language. That's why in the current trend, Python is known as all-rounder. Python is known as all-rounder. Why Python is known as all-rounder? Python is, in computer science, there are importantly, morely, we have four important types of programming language. Procedural language, then after that we have object-oriented language, then we have scripting languages, and after that we have functional programming language. Like that, he took features from almost every important programming language. He took programming, that procedural language features from, at that time famous procedural language, C language. He took procedure-oriented features from C language and object-oriented features from C++. At that time we don't have Java. Actually Java came into the market in 1995. Python came before Java. For that time, the existing good object-oriented programming language is C++. He took the features of object-oriented from C++ language. Later, he took the scripting languages features from parallel scripting languages. After that, the functional programming language features he took from Modula 3. So at that time, Modula is a well-known functional programming language for mathematics function. Our next topic is applications of Python. As I told, there are various applications of Python. I wrote some of the important applications of Python. First one is desktop application. We have Python Tkinter for graphical user interface for desktop application. Python Tkinter for GUI applications. And we can use for the desktop application, WhatsApp, all these are desktop application you can use. Then we have web application, Google Forms, network related, Gmail services. We can use Python's web framework Django for designing different web applications. Coming to the database application, we have Python database connectivity, like we have JDBC. We can connect to our database application. In gaming, we have different types of Python. Using Python, we have developed different types of games like Battlefield 2, Pirates of Caribbean. All these were developed using Python graphical user interface like Pandas 3. Then we have data analytics. The important thing of Python is we can use in the latest data analytics. We have Pandas, NumPy, Numerical Python. All these are used in data analytics. We have Keras for machine learning, artificial intelligence, TensorFlow. And in the Internet of Things, we can use a Python in Raspberry Pi coding. These are sample applications of Python. Popular search engines like Google, YouTube, they use internally Python coding. Coming to the application like different organizations, NASA, Network Stock Exchange, these applications are developed using Python only. In most top software companies like Google, Microsoft, IBM, Yahoo, they are all using Python in their organization. Next we have, what are the very important features of Python? The features of Python, the first and foremost feature is simple and easy to learn. As I told earlier, Python is very simple like English language. You can feel reading in English language statements. Its structure is very simple compared to other programming language. It has only 30 plus keywords. In 3.0 version of Python, you have only 33 keywords. If you know all 33 keywords, you are good at Python. Then the important thing of Python is reduce number of lines. And you can reduce the development cost of the project. Next we have the important second point is freeware and open source. Python, it is a free and open source. You can customize, whatever the need you require, because it is openly available on internet. You can customize depending upon your application. Then the next one is high level programming language. I told Python is a high level programming language. You are not required to go the low level tasks like memory management, security issues like this. Just it is very simple. Only the high level tasks we are doing. And coming to the next point, platform independent. Python is a platform independent. You can run the Python program whatever you did using the Windows operating system. Same you can do with a Linux operating system, Fedora or any other operating system. Next feature is portable. Python programs are portable. Means that if you are writing on a 32-bit machine, same you can compile or interpret on 64-bit machine. Like other programming language in C, you don't have that feature. In C language, if you are going with Turbo C, in 32-bit operating system, it is 2 bytes of memory it is occupying for integer. Coming to the 64-bit operating system for Linux, it is taking 4 bytes of memory. So like this, we don't have any changes in Python. So Python is portable. It is common. Its programs are common in 32-bit as well as 64-bit operating systems. Next, we have dynamically prototype language. The next very important feature of the Python is dynamically prototype language. I told earlier, in the earlier starting example 1 and example 2 programs, in C and Java language, whenever you want to use a variable, before using that variable, you need to declare what type of data you want to store in that. What type of data you want to store in that variable location. So, those are known as static programming languages. Java and C are static programming languages. But coming to the Python, it is a dynamically prototype language based upon your requirement. No need to declare explicitly like int a, like that. Depending upon the occasion, you can use your own name, a variable. You can assign the value. Suppose I am taking a is equal to 30. In Java, you need to declare explicitly int a. Then later you can initialize 30 value is assigned to a. But in Python, directly after assigning like this, without declaring data type, 30 value directly assigned to a, then a is assumed as integer. So this is known as dynamically typed programming language. C and Java languages are statically typed language. Python is dynamically typed language. Next point, Python is both procedure as well as object-oriented programming language. As I told earlier, not only procedure and object-oriented language, Python is an all-rounder. In computer science, we have 4 different types of programming language, 4 different types of domains we have. One is procedure language, then we have the development like object-oriented language, after that we have scripting languages, then we have functional programming language. So function, this Python will comes under all programming language. Python will come under all programming language. That's why Python is known as all-rounder. And the procedural language features like C and Pascal we have in Python. And object-oriented language feature like C++, Java, whatever we have object-oriented feature, we do have in Python language. So likewise, if we are using this procedure and object-oriented, we can achieve security as well as reusability. We are attaining security from procedural-oriented language and we are getting the reusability from object-oriented language. And next point, coming to the next feature of the Python, it is interpreted. Python is interpreted programming language, though it is having some compiling capability. We are not going to have a special file and we are going to compile that explicitly. Directly the Python virtual machine, PVM, is going to take care of this interpretation. Given any print, welcome to LARS, automatically it is interpreted by Python virtual machine, it is interpreted. No need to compile explicitly like C programming language. Next, we have extensible. Another feature is extensible programming language. We can use other programming language, whatever we have the legacy code, that code we can use in our Python programming language. That is extensible. Means we can use MATLAB commands in Python. All this we can extensible. By this we can achieve program efficiency. Next we have embedded Python. We can have as embedded programming language. We are using Python in Raspberry Pi programming, all these things. Then coming to the popular Integrated Development Environment, IDEs, to run our program. The popular IDEs which are available in the market, PyCharm, Visual Studio for Atom, Jupyter, IDLE, Sublime Text 3. These are all popular IDEs available currently in the market. You can use anything. Later part of the series, in the next lecture, we are going to use either PyCharm or whatever you are feeling easy, Jupyter and IDLE. We are going to start the programming using IDLE or PyCharm. Next topic is identifier. Identifier is nothing but a name in the program. In general, identifier is nothing but how a person is identified. Suppose I am identified in my college with my name Rasool. So in programming language, an identifier is nothing but a named memory location. In the memory location, with what name you are using in your program. It may be a procedure name or a method name or a variable name or a constant name, whatever it may be. So that name, general name, we are calling it as identifier. Suppose in my program, I am using Lars. If you go with this, I am using an identifier called Lars in my program. So L-O-R-D-S, all these are English language alphabets I use. Directly I have assigned 10 value to Lars. So this is valid assignment in Lars. Here my identifier name is Lars. Now, as we have studied in different programming language, we have rules to declare identifiers in Python programming language. The first rule is, only alphabets and underscores for special purpose are allowed in the Python programming language. The only allowed characters in Python, I want to declare a variable. In place of S, suppose I want to use dollar. As per the rules and regulation of identifier declaration in Python, you can't use a special character like dollar. So this is invalid assignment. Lords, L-O-R-D-S, all are lowercase letters I use, so that is valid. Next, coming to this, identifier should not start with a number or a special character. Even special characters are not allowed here. Identifier should not start with digit. So M1 is valid identifier name. You can take a variable call or identifier call M1. It is a valid variable name. But one M you can't declare because it is starting with a digit. 1M is a not valid identifier in C language, this particular Python programming language. As I told, Python is case sensitive. There is a differentiation between LORDS. Suppose I have assigned LORDS 10 value. I took another name, capital LORDS. I have assigned 100 for this. If you are printing, print LORDS, the first one, it will print 10 value. And if you are printing the second one, capital LORDS, it will print you 100 value. And even if you are changing any one character in lowercase and uppercase, total identifier will be changed. LORDS, all lowercase letters are different. Suppose you are using another name, capital, then RDS, all LORDS, like that you can use. So here L is capital, small LORDS is different. And if you are changing any one letter, that is first letter I change, L, capital letter, LORDS, it is also different. And apart from these, there is no length restriction in identifier. There is no length restriction of identifier in Python programming language. You can use a large name like online smart trainer without any space. There are no spaces are allowed in this. You can use online smart trainer without any space. You can use this. So spaces are not valid. You can give any large identifier name, but it is better to give only up to a maximum 8 character to remembering purpose. So this is about identifiers. The important rules are, identifier is nothing but a named memory location. It may be a variable name, procedure name, method name, constant name, variable name, whatever it may be. So we have some variable or identifier declaration rules. All lowercase letters or uppercase letters you can use. There is a differentiation between lowercase and uppercase letters. It should not start with a digit, and special symbols are not allowed. Here I use a dollar, it is invalid. In lots, whenever I am writing in place of S, I want to use dollar, it is invalid because I am using a special symbol dollar. And Python identifiers are case sensitive. Not only identifier, Python language itself is case sensitive. And coming to this, Python, there is no length restrictions of identifier. In C language, we have length restriction. In Java, we don't have. In Python also, we don't have any length restriction. I can use a large name like online smart trainer without any spaces. Apart from this, you can use any large name, large Institute of Engineering and Technology. This is also a valid identifier name. There is no length restriction, but it is better to use only up to max 8 characters. So this is about identifier. The next and last topic of today's session is reserved words. Reserved words, in every programming language, you have gone through the reserved words or keywords we are calling. These words are having special meaning and they have special functionality. In Python 3.0 version, we have 33 keywords. In this table, I am explaining all the 33 keywords you can see. First, we have the Boolean words, true or false. Then we have true, false, none also. Then logical operators we have AND or NOT. Then we have other keywords related to condition, if, elif, else, and the comparison operator is, or the looping construct you may go for, while, for, break, and in loops you are going to use the different keywords, reserved words like break, continue, return, in, yield, try, catch, except, finally, for exception handling. In order to define a keyword, you are using def, and in order to use object-oriented classes, you are using class. Here we have the class def, and if you want to pass the argument, we are using pass. If you want to declare a variable like global, you can use global, non-local. If you want to delete anything, we are using del, and we have lambda. Lambda is a special function which we will see in the subsequent sessions. Then we have the with, logical operator. So these are all only up to 33 keywords. If you know these 33 keywords, you are good at Python programming. And coming to this, all, if you see the table, all Python reserved words or keywords are lowercase letter except the first three, true, false, none. In these three reserved words, the first letter is capital letter. Here you can see lowercase alphabet symbols except the following three keywords in Python. The first, the three keywords we have, true, false, none. So if you are using, unfortunately, in our program, A is equal to true, T-R-U-E, all lowercase letter, it is invalid. So first letter of true is capital letter, T is capital. In false also, first letter is, F is capital. In none also, first letter capital. So by this we have completed the reserved words. So this is the end of the first lecture of Fundamentals of Python. In the next lecture, we are going to start with anyone ideally, either it is a PyCharm or Jupyter. Thank you for watching my lecture.